And I meeting of the Investigations and Government Operations Committee of 2019. Welcome, Senator Jacobs.
Sorry, I'm late.
No worries. And this is your first meeting, so I don't know if you want to make any remarks. And yours too. That's right. Yeah. Welcome to you both.
Thank you.
And on behalf of Senator Biagi, I also want to welcome the Westchester County Youth Bureau for joining us. Hi there. Welcome to Albany. So we have an agenda here. First, I believe there is a quorum. This is our legislative, or committee clerk, my legislative director, Elijah Reichland Melnick. Do we have a quorum?
We have a quorum.
Okay, terrific. So let's get through the agenda. First bill is S-254.
S-254 by Senator Kennedy, an act to amend the tax law in relation to establishing a credit for geothermal energy systems, and this bill will need to be referred to finance.
Is there a motion?
Move it.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay, the bill is reported. Next is S-435.
S-435, Senator Hoylman, an act to amend the tax law in relation to eliminating the one-year time requirement for aggregation payments.
Motion?
Second.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Bill reported. Next is S-578.
S-578 by Senator Kennedy, an act to amend the tax law in relation to the electronic filing of tax returns for brewers and distillers.
Motion?
Second.
Second. Any discussion? Votes in the affirmative?
Aye.
Any negative? Okay, great. Bill supported. Next is S-752.
S-752 by Senator Montgomery, an act to amend the tax law in relation to increasing the tax credit provided for solar energy system equipment from $5,000 to $10,000, and this will also need to be referred to finance.
Great. Is there a motion?
Motion.
Second?
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Bill supported. Next is S-983.
S-983 by Senator Breslin, an act to amend the public buildings law in relation to the authority of the Commissioner of General Services to lease public buildings.
Is there a motion?
Motion.
Second. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay. Bill's reported. And last but not least, the fine bill, S-1730.
S-1730 by Senator Skoufis, an act to amend the tax law and the administrative code of the City of New York in relation to real property transfer tax returns of limited liability companies.
Motion?
Can I?
Yes.
Talk a little bit about the...
Motion second first. Yeah.
Motion.
And second. Okay. Discussion, please.
Just a question, just an explanation of the rationale for the bill.
So this already exists in New York City. It would extend city law to the rest of the state. And basically, if you are an LLC looking to purchase, I believe it's one or two units, residential property. Residential property, you have to disclose who your owners are on a separate new document before being given the deed to that property. And so it's a disclosure bill. I know in Hudson Valley, and no doubt throughout the state, there are a lot of anonymous LLCs that are purchasing a lot of residential property. And so this serves two purposes primarily. One, I think people have a fundamental right to know who their neighbor is if an LLC purchases a home or a multifamily home next door to them. And second, for co-enforcement, if there are violations at a property with an anonymous LLC as its owner, the municipality, I've received reports, can often run into trouble identifying who to send that violation to because they don't know who the owner is. Mm-hmm. So that's, it exists in New York City. We're looking to extend it to the rest of the state.
Yeah, I guess my only concern is if I could see if, you know, a major percentage owner or the managing owner. But sometimes you may have very minor, small percentage owners, and you're requiring that for all, right?
Yeah. That's correct.
Okay. I'm the negative.
Okay. Rest, there any further?
Yes.
Yep. Bill's reported. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
Okay.
I did. How was it?